Hallo, hallo, Mic Test. These are the different types of financial data that these guys provide. Fundamental data for cryptocurrencies, historical data, sentiment data, financial API for news and tweets, macroeconomic data API. Yeah, these are all different things and they have different APIs for different things. Hello financial programmers, I'm Ritvik Dashora and I'm back with a new video and some new learnings. This is the starting of a new playlist and I got many comments on covering EODHD API. It's another financial data API. If you remember, I made an entire playlist for FMP, which is financial modeling prep. Thank you so much for giving such a great response on that playlist. And in your demand, now there's another playlist where I'm covering EODHD. This is a 3-video playlist. In the first video, I'll be explaining all different types of functionalities of EODHD. And we'll be just doing some small of coding here. In the second video, we will be making a stock screener. It's very similar to the one that we made with FMP as well. But there are some changes here, which are some of the speciality of EODHD. And the third video would talk about some Excel, MS Excel implementation of this API. So if you want to extract some financial information directly in Excel without doing any coding, then you guys should wait for that video, which will be the third video of this playlist. All the videos will be uploaded on Saturdays. And I think by now you guys already know that I upload a video every Saturday and I cover all aspects of programming in finance. If you are new to my YouTube channel, guys, on this channel, I turn all my viewers to successful financial programmers. Here I upload videos related to making trading bots, making trading strategies on PineScript, implementation of AI in finance, exploring some financial data APIs like this one, and there are many more topics. So if you guys are interested in what I am doing, then you should click on the subscribe button and also hit on the bell icon, because there are many playlists that will be coming on this YouTube channel and everything is for free. And I'm 100% sure that you will learn a lot with me here. Okay, so without any further ado, let's start. So guys, this is the website of EODHD, which is EODHD.com. And you can see that they have 30 years of data, financial information of different types of securities. What are the type of data do they provide? Fundamentals, end of the day, which is historical data, real-time data, some delayed data as well. It's 15 minutes delayed data, technical indicators data. So if you want to extract information like SMA or EMA directly without doing any calculations, they do it on their end itself, and then you just extract it directly in Python or Excel. Intraday data, screener, they have some amazing screeners. Alternative data, economic, which is macroeconomics data, delisted, forex pairs, and spreadsheets, as I mentioned, that they have some great APIs for MS Excel and Google spreadsheet as well. I'm sorry guys, my voice is not supporting me today, so please pardon me for that. Okay, in the programming languages, they offer help in Python, PHP, MATLAB, R, Excel, and so on. So, and you can see all the code examples by clicking here. We'll be referring to it in a second video. We can get a free API by clicking here. I'll just click on that after some time. This is the pricing. And that's it. So let me just click on get free API key here and let's sign up on EODHD API, right? So I'll just provide all this information and then click on register. Okay guys, so yeah, it was very simple. I think it's just one step process. I got the API key directly, so I'll just copy it from here and I'll save it somewhere. It's a free API right now. So there are some limits of using this free API, which is 20 API calls in a day, which can be extended to 500, right? You can also buy some extra limits. And this is all the information that we get for free, which is EODHD, EOD historical data only for the free package. If we have the paid package, you'll get all these other things as well. So I'll get the paid package as well. And let's see what are other things as well. But in this video, I'll be just focusing on the EOD historical data. On the top here, we have Academy to help us understand the API. They have a blog as well. I'll just directly click on the full documentation here. Right. So these are the different types of financial data that these guys provide. Fundamental data for cryptocurrencies, historical data, historical market capitalization data, sentimental data, financial API for news and tweets. That's great. Macroeconomic data API and so on. So yeah, these are all different things, and they have different APIs for different things. There are a couple of Python libraries available as well for EODHD, but they are not official, but I think these guys support those Python packages as well. But in this video, what I'll be doing is I'll be directly using the requests library to hit their API directly and get the information. I'm not using any Python library in all these three videos. So if we just click on any one of them, so for example, let's click on the fundamental data for cryptocurrencies, right? You'll see they create a URL actually, and we'll be just using this particular URL. We will customize it based on the type of data we need to get. For example, in this case, it's BTC USD. We can be doing it for, say, Apple stock, right? We have the API token here, which will be, I would say, a variable as well. And then using the requests library, we will be extracting information in Python. And then over there, I'll be just using some pandas library to clean the data, to make it, I would say, present in a tabular format. So that's the overall idea. And I have seen that in all of the type of APIs that they provide, they have links directly. So for example, in this case, sentiments analysis, they have the link directly, which can be copied and then pasted in our code and then can be customized. So that's a great thing. If we click on, say, sentiment data, which is actually, I think that's for free, it's available for free, we'll get the data for, yeah. As you can see that, it's a sentiments data of BTC, USD and Apple. You can see it's a JSON format data, a lot of things in front of you. Right now, it's very difficult to visualize, but definitely we can extract in Python and can actually convert it into tabular format to visualize it much better. This is the main focus of this video. So let's start. Let's jump to, I would say, the Google Colab. Let's use Google Colab in this video. In the next video, I'll be using Visual Studio. Just before that, guys, I have a very important information to share. Recently, I launched a course on Python for financial programming. So if you are trying to learn Python for finance from scratch, then this is something that you might be interested in. Just go to my website, which is fpretwick.com/python. Over here, you will see two buttons, Indian candidates, non-Indian candidates. So you can click as per your location. It will redirect you to this, the main website where the entire course information is available. You'll see that there are 5 sessions, 10 chapters, 22 videos, 10 quizzes and 3 assignments with 2 live projects. And this is the entire syllabus of this course for all the people who are interested to learn Python from scratch and who are struggling learning Python on their own. I highly recommend it because it's very, very affordable, and I have covered a lot of things from a very, very simplistic eyesight. And in the end, in session 4 and 5, you'll see stock analysis and investment portfolio creation projects, which are my personal projects. We did it using some financial analysis. If you use RTK40 code, you'll get an instant 40% discount, which is only available for the first 100 candidates. So yes, guys, I'll see you in the course. Let's come back to our code. Okay, guys, so this is Google Colab. I've given the name of this file as EODHD Video 1. I'll import requests library here. This is the URL that I copied from there for historical data. I will actually provide the API key as a variable. So I'll just write API key here, but for that I'll have to provide it inside the F string. API token is equal to API key, right? Here I will provide the API key. That's one thing. Second is the ticker should also be a variable, which is ticker here. The variable, say ticker is AAPL dot, I think they use dot US everywhere. So yeah, it was MCD.US, so it should be AAPL.US as well. And the other things can actually be kept like this only. Perfect. So I have provided the API key above, and the URL is here. Perfect. Now what I'm going to do here is I'll just write data is equal to, I'll be using requests library. I just wrote req and then Google Colab is giving me this suggestion, which is requests.get, and then inside this I will provide the URL. I want it into the JSON format, so .json, right? Now let me just zoom it a bit. Yeah, perfect. Now if you see data, it will be a big dictionary with a lot of data inside it. So let's see what are the keys of this dictionary? Okay, it's a list, it's not a dictionary. So let's see what is the length of this particular list. It's 10766. That's a lot. Perfect. I'm directly gonna use pandas library here to make it in a tabular format. So data frame df is equal to pd dot data frame, and then inside this I'll just provide data, and then let's see what is df. Perfect. So this is the historical data. Then the data is also available from 1980 of Apple. So I think it's since the beginning only. So yes, guys, you can see that the data frame, the historical data in front of you. What are the type of data which are available? These are date, open, high, low, close, adjusted close, and volume. This data is free of cost if you use EODHD. And that's the main focus of this video as well. In the next video, I'll be covering the paid version of EODHD as well. The main focus of this video was to make you understand the documentation, because in the next video, I'll go very deeper into the documentations of other APIs as well. Guys, if you like my work, as you can see, I spend a lot of time to make the content, and to be honest, it's my hobby, but I need some motivation as well. Just give me that 2 clicks. One is click on the like button, and second is click on the subscribe button. That's it, guys. I'm not asking for anything else. It really helps, because most of my viewers are not subscribing to my YouTube channel. I don't know why. They just come here, learn, and then go. But if you just give me those 2 clicks, that would be very helpful for me, and it will give me motivation to keep on going. For any freelancing inquiries, just reach out to me on this email address and I will reply to you as soon as possible. The next video would be about how to make a detailed stock screener using Streamlit and EODHD API. And yes, guys, last but not the least, the link of my course is in the description box. Just check it out and let me know if you have any feedbacks. Thank you so much, guys, for watching this video till the end. You can click here to subscribe to my YouTube channel, and over there you'll see this entire playlist of EODHD. This is the first video, and there are 2 more videos that are coming, and over there you'll see my highly loved video on making an MT5 trading bot. Stay tuned to my YouTube channel, and I'll see you next Saturday. Until then, peace.